Thank you. I'm not with fear, I'm just one of them. Some of y'all been in God for so long that you can forget that you love. That's just Jesus. I'm going somewhere. You can be with a person for so long, you can say, oh, that's just my husband, that's just my wife. But then you need to go on vacation with them. And all of a sudden you realize, I love you more than I love you. Look at this. See, some of y'all need to go on vacation with Jesus. You need to get away from the rat race. You need to get away from your cell phone. You need to get away from your TV. You need to get away from your iPad. You need to get away from your Facebook. You need to get away from your Twitter. You need to get away from your Instagram. And you need to get next to Jesus. And you need to come right here. Come on.
Your name, Jesus. No. I don't.
No weapon formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue which rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn.
Thank you, Lord.
See, there's been some.
Thank you, Jesus.
There's been some weapons that have been formed against us. But that weapon is not going to prosper. we taking no stuff and putting it out today.
There's
no 72-hour notice to comply. I'm not giving you 24 hours to comply. I'm going to walk the sheriff, and me and the sheriff will be about to be drop. It's that little by for that we walked over for years, and that thing never bothered us. But all of a sudden, when we begin to step over it, we're going to move away. And we think, okay, I can get over that. And then it tripped us. It messed us. And we're in a position, and we don't realize how we got in that position. But if we are in the right position with God, and the love of God is in our hearts, then the little things, He'll keep us from tripping. Because if you are not one with Him, then anything can mess us up. Because we think we can do it by ourselves. But there's no way that I can walk this walk without Him. There's no way that I could have raised 3 kids without Him. There's no way that I could have been married as long as I've been married without Him. Because you know, I'm not the easiest person to get along with.
So much, Jesus.
The blood has never lost its power. The scripture says that no weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. And there was weapons that was formed against me, but the weapons were not able to prosper because it was the goodness and mercy of God that was able to keep me.
Jesus.
See, some people think, well, a lot of people say that preachers got it easy. They think money just flows to them. Yes, the money in our pockets and our kids are perfect, right? Our lives are perfect, right? It's a more of a struggle for us than it is the lay saint, because we have a standard that we have got to live up to, because God has put us in that position. And people expect for you to give them advice over everything that transpires. And sometimes I'm at a loss for words. I understand their pain, but sometimes all I can do is listen. And sometimes maybe that's all we're supposed to do, is and let them vent, let them get it off their chest. And once they get it off their chest, they can move on. That's how. Because the Lord told me one time, this was a day to me, telling me all this stuff, and I didn't know what to say. And God said, He just wants you to listen. And I listened, and He felt better, and we moved on. Hold on. But you have got to love God. Because God loves you. Angel, let's sing that song. No weapon formed against me. And we're gonna go home. I'm gonna go home. I'm gonna jump with you. I don't know if y'all want to. houses to the art canina or whatever I'm going on. No weapon formed against me. Look at this.
It won't
work. Oh, Holy Ghost. push you through the water. God said, I'm going to push you through the water now. God said, I'm going to push you through out of this thing. My God, my God. Beat me the way they did. I want to push you back. If God don't push us through those weapons, then we stay right here looking at the weapons. And I don't want to stay looking at the weapons. Push me. I got to push. If I don't move the weapon out of my way, the weapon is going to destroy me. So I've got to be able to move the weapon out of my way. Because this weapon that has been formed is not going to prosper, Joe. So many roadblocks have been set up in your way. The enemy has tried to set you up for failure. And then as many times as the enemy has tried to leave this place, you always end up coming back. You try to leave with both feet in the ground, boom, 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 boom. And you always come back with both feet in the ground, boom, boom, boom. Why? Because God has called you. And you can't understand why God loved you so much. I don't understand why He loved me so much. But He does. So I accept. So just accept that God loves you. Talking for a minute. It doesn't matter what you have done. It don't matter. God ain't concerned about what you did last week, 2 months ago, whatever. God ain't concerned about that. God is concerned about John sitting in this chair right now. And John needs to be healed. See, so look at this. Look at this. Watch this. I don't know, but you know what's going on in your life right now, right? You know what's going on. Push. No weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. The scripture says, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And it's time to do some confessing that He is Lord. God bless you.
Supposed to give some time to the Lord. And when you are at the ball game, are you watching the clock? Well, quick look.
Amen. Amen.
So that means you're supposed to get with him, and he's supposed to get with you. And you're supposed to keep him in your heart. You're supposed to love him with all of your heart. You're supposed to serve him with everything that you have. We live in an evil day in our country and in every other country in the world. Evil is proliferating everywhere. Amen. And the scripture says evil shall wax worse and worse. So, where are you going to hide? You've got to hide in him. You've got to hide in him. And I'm sure you're tired of being scared. Come on. You're tired of being scared. Don't tell me you're not scared. You know, folks, you go around the street, go down the street, and folks are looking at you like this. You one of them. I don't know what them it might be, but get in your car. Folks look at you and lock their door. What you look like?
One of them.
You go snatch them or go snatch something. Somebody told me they were down in a certain part of the city to pick up somebody from a place. And they kept their cell phone up and they weren't talking about it. They were trying to make sure that the people that were floating around there probably had some connection. But what I want you to know that you have some connection when you get lost. He's your protector.
Amen.
He's your director.
Amen.
He's everything you need when you get lost. So I mean that may be a nice ruse, you know, act like you're talking on the cell phone, keep folks from bothering you, but you need Jesus.
Very cool.
Who is there that really accepted Christ as their Savior and wants to do it right now? We need another room. They always call. She gave a testimony today of how she has been her wheelchair. She has an electric wheelchair, and the wheelchair motor gave out or whatever. So the guy that came to push her and help her out, she asked him, "Did he know the Lord?" He said, "No." Then, "Would you like to?" He said, "Yes." She led him in the sinner's prayer.
Bless your name.
Nine years, but we just met, and he just came to say hello, and we have something to say. You want to say something? Praise the Lord. Right? That's great. I wish you were here, but I love to honor that. I gotta go back. Got no work. Okay, for a while here. You listen to that. Okay, well, we're happy for you. We have two visitors. Here, he's not a visitor, he's home. But we have Sean Johnson. God bless you, sir.
Amen.
That's our girl. Amen. You're the kid to her. Is your brother? No. Is she your kid? Well, you're going to do right by her.
Yes.
Yes, sir. God loves her. I'll get you doing things.
Amen. That's true. Amen. I'm serious. Yeah. Better listen.
Yes, Lord. Everybody in here is are my children.
Right.
And I pray for them. And I said, now, Lord. Now we have Marquise here. Where's Marquise? Is that good, right? Marquise here. Thank you, baby. Oh, thank you for being here.
Oh, amen.
I was looking for, she had a Marina, they call her, but Marina, we call her. She had, I guess, about 8 people here from the tournament. Our family are here for her birthday. And I thought it was so awesome to invite you to church for your birthday.
Amen.
We don't have to speak our because we missed her. All right, anybody else? I didn't remember this young man, little white one. Have you been here before for a year at Sunday? You were here?
Yeah.
You were here?
No.
Okay, okay. Well, I can't look at you. You know the Lord? You do. Real good. Don't you feel I'm still living for whoever it is that's in my spirit here. Somebody. But I'm just praying for you. I pray for you and I pray for folks that I haven't seen for years. And God bless you.
Amen.
Oh, thank God for Jesus. Anybody want to be saved today?
I do. I want to be saved. Oh, I do.
I believe it.
Yeah, amen.
Anybody that maybe have you been here before? Have you been here before? You have? Okay, perfect. Who didn't raise his hand when the teacher asked him if they wanted to go to heaven? So she asked why he didn't raise his hand. He said, well, I thought they were picking up the baby.
I don't care. I go today. Hey.
That's why you didn't raise your hand. Now, how many want to be saved? Okay. We're going to dismiss you and let you go home. Come back next Sunday at 12:30 and you're going to preach again. You come to 10 o'clock and hear me, but you can hear the lady.
Amen. Thank you.
Going once. Going once. Twice. Shall we stand? Gracious Father, we're so thankful for all that you've brought in our lives, even today. Now, this is the day that you have made. We're rejoicing and we're glad. We thank you for our musicians and the equipment that we've received that has blessed us.
Amen.
Understand there's more to come. We just thank you for all of your many, many blessings. We pray that you look upon those that are sick, those that are grieving loss. We pray that you comfort and strengthen. Lord, we know you can do it because you've done it through us. We pray now that you would just keep us in the center of your will, direct our path, order our course, then let the words of our mouth.